الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. Our actions are related to our intentions. And as most of us are aware of the hadith of Umar ibn al-Khattab رضي الله تعالى عنه, where the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إنما أعمال بالنيات. He said, verily actions are tied to the intentions. And just looking at this part of the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, verily actions are tied to the intentions. Sheikh Muhammad Salih bin Uthaymeen, rahimahullah ta'ala, one of the great scholars of our time, said in regards to just this portion of the hadith, he gave an example to make it clear for us the meaning of the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Sheikh said, وَلِنَضْرَبْ مِثْلًا بِالصَّلَاةِ. He said, and we'll give an example with the prayer. رَجُلٌ أَرَادَ أَنْ يُسَلِّي ظُهْرٌ. So a man, he wants to pray the ظُهْر prayer. فَيَجِبُ أَنْ يَنْوِي الظُهْر حَتَّ تَمَيْزْ عَنْ غَيْرِهَا. So he said, the man who wants to pray the ظُهْر prayer, he must have the intention to pray dhuhr in order to distinguish from other prayers. How do we know that this is the dhuhr prayer that you're going to pray? You know this in accordance with your intention. وَإِذَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ ظُهْرَانَ فَيَجِبُ أَنْ يُمَيِّزْ الظُّهْرَ الْأَمْسِ ظُهْرَ أَمْسِ عَنْ ظُهْرَ الْيَوْمِ. So if the man has to pray two dhuhrs, meaning he's responsible for a missed dhuhr prayer from yesterday, for example, and then today's dhuhr prayer that he is to pray. The way he's going to distinguish those two prayers is by his intention. His intention will distinguish because they're both of those prayers are four prayer units, four rakats. And the Sheikh said, لِأَنَّ كُلُّ صَلَاةٍ لَهَا نِيَّةٍ. And he said, and this is because every prayer requires intention. So that was a beautiful example the Sheikh was illustrating for us, that we distinguish our worship. Worship is distinguished in accordance with our intention. Our intention is what helps us to distinguish our worship from our regular habits. Are you doing exercise? Are you doing yoga poses? Or are you doing the prayer, the Islamic prayer? What's going to determine that is by your intention. Is your intention to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do you intend ibadah? Do you intend and are you following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Because we know that that's the second condition for having our deeds accepted. The first is that we have sincerity for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the second is that we do it in accordance with the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I ask Allah the Almighty to forgive us of our sins and grant us good in this life as well as the hereafter. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.